Did you know that no two countries with a McDonald's, they've never gone to war with each other? Did you know that?
No.
Well, no, I didn't know that.
Yeah, because everyone's way too lazy after they get fat.
China and the U.S. haven't gone to war because there's a McDonald's in China and then there's a McDonald's here.
Really? No, I didn't know that.
Two countries?
Yeah. Did you know?
No, I didn't know that.
Wouldn't surprise me.
Is that really true?
It's true.
Nobody had heard of the Golden Arches theory of conflict prevention before, but I put them on the spot and asked them for a possible explanation.
Why do you think that is?
Because good food tastes good.
Globalization of the economy.
Once you have a McDonald's in your country, your motivation just goes way down.
Have a McDonald's, you've reached a certain status, I guess, and that makes you more first world, I don't know.
Maybe countries that bring in McDonald's accept Americans a little more freely?
I don't know.
This correlation between McDonald's and peace can lead to some interesting policy conclusions. So I asked another question.
So do you think that if every country in the world had a McDonald's, there'd be world peace?
Absolutely not.
I don't think so, because that's different way that everybody think. I wish everybody agreed to do it, but I don't think so.
I'm skeptical that it's true, actually.
It's called the Golden Arches theory of conflict resolution.
Okay.
Correlation does not mean causation. So.
That's words of wisdom.
That would be nice, wouldn't it?
Guess you go to McDonald's to get that Big Mac. You have that smile on your face. You don't think about anything.
McDonald's originated here, right? So, I mean, I just don't think it's in their best interest to be putting up McDonald's in places that they're at war with.
I mean, it stretches too far. There's no way to correlate the data.
I think there probably is something more driving the conflict than not having a McDonald's.